Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's Kirito before here bringing you another episode of Let's Build a Desert Bombing Range. And in this episode, we'll be going ahead and trying to build the road that leads out to the range while also putting a pretty much a main road in, kind of like a desert highway-ish type thing. Now, I have a few little ideas for this map that it's not just going to be a bombing range. It's actually going to have a few more things on it. I kind of want to put like a little bit of a town or something, maybe down the road from the range. So I'm not 100% sure on how that's all going to work out, but I'm going to try to. I mean, you probably realistically wouldn't have a town this close to a bombing range. But I mean, it's the desert. I mean, it's way out in the middle of nowhere. So we can just kind of role play that it's more down the road, of course. But, you know, we will just have to see. But anyways, basically, I went ahead and did a little bit of work off camera on the range. As you guys can see, I went ahead and put the details in with the sand and stuff. I felt like this would have been a very tedious process, so I just went ahead and did it off camera because I felt it would be a little bit tedious, as I just said. So in the last episode, we went ahead and pretty much set the rings, and we also built the rusted tank, which I got a lot of feedback from. You guys really seemed to like that, so I'm glad to hear it. So anyways, you can see here we have all the little impacts from the bombs coming down and hitting. You can see it's very nice shape to it around the whole circle, and the rusted M48 patents on a little bit of a pedestal there in the bombing range. So it's pretty cool, and again, a lot of you guys went ahead and liked the patent really a lot, and some of you guys even asked for a little bit of a tutorial for it, which I may do. Not 100% sure yet, but I mean, it's overall pretty cool, so I can see why. And then I added a few little bushes around just like that, just to kind of add a little bit more to it. And I think it came together pretty well. So that's pretty much the main part of the bombing range. Now, I'll probably add a little bit of stuff around it. I'm not quite sure how much really I'm going to add, but I mean, this is pretty much the main bombing range itself that we want to have set up. So since we have that done, we need to make the service road that leads out from it. And this is going to be made out of dirt, and trying to show it in the sand and stuff like that, because it's going to be a sand road and all that. But one thing I want to figure out is what kind of materials should we use for roads. Now, I'm going to be building this in the default texture pack, so I'm not sure yet on what kind of roads I want to use. So I got to figure that out, what kind of materials. I don't really want to use wool, so I'm thinking lean toward the stained clay, but I'm not 100% sure, so that's something I'll just have to figure out, I guess, over time and building it and all that stuff. So anyways, I kind of had a good idea for the roads here. I think what we'll be using is pretty much some sandstone. We're just going to go and basically take sandstone, go all the way down like this, and that's going to make a nice texture to it, and kind of look a little bit more hardened and stuff, a little bit more traveled. And we're also going to put down sandstone half slabs alongside. Now, one person also, I believe it was Terrence, if I remember correctly, from the comments, went ahead and said that we should go ahead and try using some paths, some grass paths. Now, I'm not sure how well these will look. I think it might be a little too dark, but I think we can make it work. Like, maybe these are like the worn down sections of the road. For those of you guys that have not been to the desert or really have gone off-roading or anything like that, in sand and stuff like that, a lot of times when you actually get past like the actual top layer of sand, it's actually kind of like the sand's a little moist underneath it, and it has like a brownish color to it. So we could actually kind of show that with the paths, by maybe making like the tire tracks from vehicles basically creating over time and stuff like that from driving over it and stuff like that. And I mean, it looks decent. I think it looks all right. So I'm not 100% sure on how that's going to work out, but we're just going to have to see how that all goes and all that stuff. And we'll just kind of take the tracks, kind of make them a little bit all over the place, and not exactly, completely even, just because it's going to look a little bit better, kind of spread out like that or whatever, different vehicles driving at different sections of it or whatever. So it'll be something kind of like that. We're going to kind of create the tracks that lead all the way out to the road itself, which will probably be somewhere out in that section here. And as I mentioned, we'll have the sandstone all the way down as well. So then we'll just go ahead and take our sandstone half sides, place it down the sides of the road, and we should have ourselves a nice little service road out to the bombing range. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Scaretooth here, bringing you another episode of my Let's Build a Desert Bombing Range. For those of you guys that haven't seen the first episode, I highly recommend you guys go and check that out, because we went ahead and basically set up our range here, and it's looking pretty awesome. As you guys can see, I've done a little bit of work off camera, though. I've added a lot of the details around the range, such as the piled up sand and a lot of the craters and stuff like that from the impacts from bombs and stuff like that. And overall, it really made it come together. Now, I decided to go and do that off camera because it was a lot of tedious work. It took me about an hour to do all of it. So, I mean, it wasn't going to be very entertaining as a video to do. So, I decided to just go ahead and do it off camera because I felt that it would be a little bit easier for you guys to actually watch and enjoy. So, as you guys can see, we have the circles we set up. We did that in the last episode. And we also built the rusted M48 Patton over there, which a lot of you guys seem to enjoy, which I'm really happy about. And some of you guys even wanted a tutorial for it. So we'll have to see. I'm not quite sure if I will, but we'll just have to see. So we have that set up. You can see around the range, a lot of craters, piled up sand, impacts, and all that stuff. Overall, it looks really good. I really like the way it came out, and you got a few bushes kind of scattered around, which just makes the range look a whole lot better. And basically, the tank itself, it's kind of raised on a platform here. You guys can kind of see the ground kind of goes down a little bit, and then it pops up there in the center there where the tank is kind of resting on, which I think looks really nice. And also, if hopefully I don't forget, but I want to show you guys the pictures of the actual range as I promised I would in this episode. So hopefully I put those on screen or something right about now. But I also want to go ahead and let you guys know that we'll be starting another Let's Build series. It'll probably be some sort of military themed Let's Build, as that's what you guys like to do or like to see, really. And I've basically canceled my Northport series for those of you guys that have watched my previous video. I basically said that I was going to be stopping work on my Northport series and, you know, starting to go ahead and work on this actual, these actual kind of projects and stuff like that, which I enjoy a lot more. So anyways, I think it's going to be for the best. We're going to have a lot of cool new Let's Build coming and all that stuff. And let's go ahead and start building. And I think the first thing we're going to be doing is working on our service road that leads out to our, basically, a little bit of highway. Now, the highway is going to be out somewhere over there a little bit before that mound of sand. You can see it starts to kind of form into a kind of like a hill. And we want to have a highway that kind of goes straight across there, kind of maybe curves and goes down that way. So we'll just have to kind of see how that all turns out. But let's go ahead and get started by working on the service road here. And I think I had some good ideas. I want to kind of show you guys the ideas before I go and do a little bit of stuff off camera. So, one awesome suggestion I got was from Terrence. I believe it was Terrence. I could be wrong. Not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure it was Terrence. And basically what he suggested is if I go ahead and take grass here, and then go ahead and do something like this, and leave a space of 3 because most of my big military trucks are 3 blocks wide. We go ahead and do that, right? We have our grass blocks. If we go ahead and right-click on the sand, we can grass, we can actually turn it into grass paths. And I think they're going to be really nice for the actual kind of, you know, actual tracks that get worn in from the vehicles going down the same road over and over again. And for those of you guys that have not been out to the desert, a lot of times when you have fresh trails and stuff like that, they're cut into the sand underneath it will be kind of a brownish color from it being kind of moist. It's a little wet. It's interesting, right? You wouldn't expect sand to be actually wet, but it actually is underneath the layer of just regular sand above it. That's because of you know, the water, groundwater, and all that stuff. So this could actually work, and actually it's really nice because it actually shows that there's actually, you know, it's actually lower than the sand, which is perfect. I mean, it really works, and I really like that idea. And it just adds a whole lot of texture to it. I think that's gonna be really nice. So. Basically, we're just going to have a road that kind of goes pretty much straight out back that way, and it's going to look pretty good. I'm also thinking about taking some smooth sandstone blocks and just kind of putting them down along the road, just to kind of give it a little bit more, what's the word I'm looking for, a little bit more to it, kind of like show it just a little bit more packed in than just a regular sand, stuff like that. So I'll just have to see how that goes, but overall, I think it's going to be pretty nice, and we'll go ahead and do a little bit of work off camera, and I'll come back and show you guys our progress once we get a little bit done. And yeah, I'll see you guys in a sec. Alrighty guys, so quick little progress update. I went ahead and kind of messed around with this area. I kind of got the idea, you know how when you kind of have like a dirt road or something like that, kind of leads into an area, a lot of times you have just like the different tracks from the tires and stuff like that from vehicles that just kind of spread out and go kind of crazy all over the place. Well, I went ahead and did this, so you have like the main route right here that's going to lead out. And then you come in here and it just has a bunch of different tracks that spread off into different sections. And I think it came out pretty cool. I mean, I'm going to tweak it a little bit, mess around with it a little bit more. But it's kind of a cool little concept. And I I think it looks pretty cool. But just that, it just kind of shows that that's actually like an entrance and kind of shows what I wanted to show. So I really like that. So I just want to go ahead and give you guys a little progress update, and let's go ahead and continue working on this. Alrighty, guys. So welcome back. As you guys see, we did a little bit more work on the road, but I just want to show you guys just look how beautiful these cactus look. Oh my god, they look so good, especially with the foliage mod. And look, it'll add like these little random little parts that kind of stick out. So good. I absolutely love it. Love the foliage mod. So beautiful. But yeah, just the cactus look good. So I want to put like a little bit of cactus around, maybe some bushes or stuff like that. Or is it actually cacti? That's the plural. I think it's cacti actually. So we'll put some cacti around. You can see here the road, kind of like the style is going with. I kind of decided to go ahead and mix some endstone in. It kind of looks like a little bit of like cracked sand or something like that, like or cracked mud or something, like when it rains or whatever, and it dries out, it starts to crack all the mud. So I thought of something kind of like that. I mean, I think it looks cool. I mean, I'm just gonna put it around a little random spots here and there, but I really like it. And you can see here we just got some sand that's kind of in the middle here that kind of just gets piled up over time or whatever, and you just have your tracks that come out like this, and they're kind of broken up a little bit by sand. I thought it would look a little bit better if we went ahead and did that, and it sure does. But anyways, I'm liking the way the road's going so far, so let's go ahead and continue back to work and, you know, see where we can get with this. Alright guys, welcome back. I went ahead and put the road in, the service road. It's all pretty much built up and ready to go, and overall just looking pretty awesome. Now, I went ahead and built the road a little bit. I'm going to kind of talk about the service road real quickly. So it's pretty cool. I like the way it came out. I think it's pretty nice. It's got some good little details on it, and overall looks pretty good. So obviously the service road comes from there. We were building that earlier. It comes down here, and I decided to go ahead and put a split section in. Now I would imagine that some days probably some kind of management crew or something would go out there, and they would be picking up all of the bombs and stuff like that to be taken back for scrap metal. So you would have kind of maybe some trucks going back and forth carrying these bombs, and I wanted to put a section here in the road where if a truck was coming, it could go down this way, and then a vehicle could go down this way so that you wouldn't, you know, get stuck or anything like that. Just make things flow a little bit better. So I decided to go ahead and make it a double wide one, and it came out pretty nice. And then you have the road back here. It just continues all the way here to the road in which it has the turnoff. So you would have the military vehicle turn off and basically go down the road and stuff like that to wherever they need to go. Now, I was kind of sitting here thinking about how we can go ahead and, you know, have the entrance of the bomb range. And I kind of thought one of the cool features we can do is maybe build some kind of guard shack that has one of those little pole things that go across the road the road that you would lift up or whatever. And I found a cool guard shack design that I think I'm going to go ahead and try to put in here. So that's what we're going to do. And we want kind of a little bit down the ways of the road, probably maybe about this section right here. Just so that if you have like a bigger truck coming through or something, it can kind of get off the road and not be, you know, sticking out too much or whatever. A little bit of a convoy, who knows. So we're going to go ahead and put the tower in right here. Now we want to go ahead and start off by giving it a concrete base, so we're probably going to be using some polished andesite for that. Probably would look the best in this case. So we're just going to go ahead and basically make ourselves a pretty good sized shack here. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, probably 9 blocks long. And a few things also I want to go ahead and throw in there real quick. This road right here is going to go ahead and cut through that hill right there, and it's going to have like some walls on the side here. Is going to just cut through that mountain and just continue on through. And then the road's going to lead off that way, probably to where we're going to be building a town or something of that sort in the future. But overall, pretty cool stuff. So it's going to be really nice. And also, a little ways down the road, we're going to have another turnoff, and that's going to have like the kind of like a almost like a scrapyard, I guess, for some of the extra bombs. It's going to have a bunch of, it's going to have a radio tower for communicating to pilots coming in. Maybe some, you know, other tanks and stuff they can roll out there to be bombed and stuff like that, since the patent's kind of getting a little old down the way. So, just some cool stuff, just kind of making up what I would imagine would be in a, kind of like in a military-ish type scenario. So, overall, pretty cool stuff. I'm looking forward to really seeing how this is going to turn out, and I think it's going to be really cool. So, we have that set up. That's going to pretty much be the front portion here of the guard shack. We're also going to go ahead and grab ourselves some fence posts, because I have a cool idea with this. we can go ahead and put some fence posts like this for the pylons that they would have, or like the long, kind of like the long concrete poles, I guess. Go ahead and put those up like that for it. I think it looks all right. Maybe we can take it down a notch. Man, I think it sticks out just a little bit too much. It seems a little too small there too, but I don't know. I think that will work. We might change that later on, but for right now, that's what we pretty much want. Now, for the guard shack itself, what kind of material do we want to make it out of? Now, this is something I'm not quite sure of. I don't know if I want to make it like a green color or just go with like a concrete-ish type color. So that's something I gotta kind of figure out here. I'm not necessarily sure on what I want to do for it. Let's kind of see here. We could make it out of cyan stained clay. Just go ahead and make it gray. And it's gonna kind of end on your side there. It's not gonna go all the way. So it's something kind of like that. So if we go ahead and do something like so, I think that will work out pretty nice. And then there'll be the door right there-ish. Or actually, we'll go ahead and do this. We'll put a window in right here. And then there'll be a window across like that. And then it'll come along here. All the way like this and go across like this. Probably have a window right here. We're going to raise this all up a little bit here. So again, that's our doorway there. It's going to come across. Have our windows. Like so. Could even make them a little bit bigger. I think they're fine, actually. I think that would be fine how they are. And let's see. Do we want to put any windows on the back side here? No, we won't put any windows on the back side here. We'll just go ahead and cover that up. And same thing over here. Just go ahead and cover that all up just like that. So you have basically a small, kind of simple little guard shack right here. Pretty much a basic outline for it. I think that's good. I think that's what we want. And then we'll just take our polished andesite and go ahead and fill in these spaces just like this around like that. And I kind of feel like we could add a little bit more to it just to make it stand out a little bit more. So let's see, what could we use for this? Anything really in particular stands out to me. Fortunately, nothing's really standing out. Let's see, maybe we can use some stone bricks on the bottom level here. Maybe that will help it a little bit. I want to add some detail to it. I don't want it to be just completely plain and stuff like that. I want it to look cool for a guard shack. I mean, it's just a guard shack, so it doesn't need to be anything special by all means, but I just want to kind of make it look, you know, presentable, a little bit, you know, nicer than just, you know, just looking like it's half-assed, really. So if we go ahead and do that, put another pylon here on either side, we have that right there, so that's all set up, that's good to go. Of course, we would have a door here, and we can go ahead and fill this in by doing // set 1,6, and I'll fill that in with some concrete fork, something of that kind of sort. And once we go ahead and finish that up, we're going to take some stone brick half slabs. We'll put some across like this. We'll have it overhang a little bit. Alrighty, guys, so going ahead and continuing on, I went ahead and went off camera, finished off a few little things around the guard shack, was messing around with some detail bits, put the windows in and the doors. I kind of made the windows a little bit bigger. I felt that they fit it a lot better, so I went ahead and did that. I like the way that looks. And the roof, everything, I'm pretty satisfied with it. Now, I want to go ahead and actually add something to the top up here. So you can see on the top here, it's really flat. We don't want it to be super flat. So I want to go ahead and add maybe like a satellite in. You know, the guards have to have their dish network or something going on in here. Who knows? But they're gonna have like some kind of like little satellite thing that kind of comes off of this. So I'm trying to think of how I can actually go ahead and go about doing this. See, maybe if we go ahead and take something up like that. So just like that, so a little bit of a pillar there. Actually, we may want to go ahead and adjust this here to something like that. I was thinking about doing something a little bit different, but when I started building it, this kind of turned, this is what kind of came out of it. So we'll go ahead and take that, switch those to full blocks there. And if we go ahead and grab ourselves some iron bars, we'll go ahead and place down maybe a row 2 of iron bars, or row 4 actually. Followed by one that sticks out on either side, so it's like that. So you got like a little bit of like a satellite thing on the top there, but I feel like that looks a little weird. Looks too big, really, if you ask me. Not gonna do that. Just again, a little too big for what I want. I don't know. I could leave it for right now and maybe come back to it, but I definitely want to change that a bit. It just doesn't feel right to me. So we'll probably fix that or something off camera. You know, maybe in the next episode or something like that. And we also just want, of course, like some kind of antenna or something kind of coming up. Let's see. Let's go ahead and do something just like that. The shack. So something like that, and looks pretty decent. We can also give them like maybe an AC unit. We could be nice here to these guards. See, now in the desert, definitely gonna need some kind of AC and stuff like that, because it can get super damn hot out there. So if we go ahead and grab ourselves some rails and stuff, make ourselves like a nice little AC unit on the top there, and should be pretty much. Dude, we don't want to do that because I don't want that to connect up. So I'm gonna go ahead and fix that. Let's see, do something kind of like that. I mean, this is good. It's simple. It's nice. It adds a little bit more to the roof. I'm still not sure about that. I might switch this out. Maybe we can make it a little bit smaller like that. Maybe that'll look better. Yeah, I feel like that looks a little bit better. So yeah, we got that set up. That's good to go. Now we also want to go ahead and put in the little lift gate here. So we may actually go ahead and delete this pole right here and put it in, or we could put it in right next to this pole. I'm trying to think of how I can really do this, because I'm not really 100% sure kind of like how they look. So I mean I have a general idea of what it looks like, but I don't know if I'll be able to actually get it right. So if we go ahead and do something like that, we can go ahead and maybe grab ourselves some quartz and some nether rack, because nether rack kind of has a reddish color to it. And we'll place down a quartz, then nether brick, quartz, nether brick, and it's raining again. Man, I swear, rains like crazy on this map, or just in all my maps in general. I wish I could just completely turn it off, but it's kind of annoying if you ask me. So we have that kind of goes across. We can go ahead and put a red stained clay block. Ooh, that looks a bit weird. Okay. Never mind, we won't do that, because I was thinking about putting the red stained clay block there for a stop sign, but if we put it down there, it won't look right, and it just won't look right overall. So we'll just have to go with something kind of like that. I mean, it looks good. It looks all right still, so it's not that major. But you got your little gate there, and all that stuff. So that's gonna pretty much, you know, be used to keep everybody out, and all that kind of stuff. But anyways, guys, I think that's where I'm gonna go and call the episode here. I mean, probably not a lot will be actually shown in the video, because I was working mostly on just this road and this one here, which was a lot of work, by the way. I mean, I spent a few hours actually putting this all in. Believe it or not, I did this all by hand. I felt that it would look a lot better with the detail wise and stuff. It wouldn't just be like symmetrical or anything with the world edit. So I put this all in by hand, and kind of worn out. So I'll probably call the episode here. Let me know down in the comments below what you guys think about the let's build so far. What do you guys think I should add to it? We're definitely gonna have some kind of aircraft coming in and doing a bombing run. I definitely want to do that, because that would be really cool. But other than that, that's pretty much gonna do it for this episode. Hope you guys did enjoy, and as always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Absolutely failing on this intro here, or this outro. I'm just gonna stop myself there. But anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. As always, for like, comment, and subscribe. This has been Gear 2x4, and I'll see you guys next time.